Welcome to Technology Point. In this video, we are going to see about the manage table. In the manage table, the use of the manage table is that once we are creating a normal table in the SQL or Hive, the table is created. For example, we are going to create a table like create table EMP1. Employee1 is I named it as EMP1, and I am going to provide the four columns: employee number, name, designation, and the employee department, and terminated by like slash t, which is nothing but the tab delimited values. Okay, and I am going to load data into the EMP1 table. Once I load the data into the EMP table, I am going to run a query on a manage table by using the employee designation. I am going to count the values. Once I counted the values by using the group by employee designation, once I am done with that, what I am going to do is that I am going to drop a manage table. Why we are going to drop a manage table is nothing but once we drop the manage table, the data present inside the Hive, all the metadatas and the stored values will be lost. For example, if you are creating a table, like we are creating a table with employee 1, the full data that present in the employee in number, name, all the values will be dropped, as well as the metadata, all the data will be lost. Okay, that is the main drawback in the manage table. When we are creating an external table, what is the use of the external table is that once we are created the external table, that once we are going to drop the external table, the only thing is that the employee, that like the metadata only information will be lost. That is the only drawback of the external table. But in case of the manage table, the data and all the metadata will be lost. The metadata is the place where the data informations will resides on, that it will has a record showing that this data is stored in this location. That information will be contained inside the metadata. Okay, we will see more in depth in this by explaining in the cloud lab. Okay, let's go into the cloud lab now. I already sign in into the cloud lab. I will show you in that. I'm going to show you the, like, I'm going to create a table now. I have created a table. I am going to delete it by using the show tables. First I will check the table whether I have created the table name. Okay, the table doesn't exist now. Okay, I will create a new table now. Create table EMP1. I'm going to employee number. I'm going to provide it as the type is int. Employee number, employee name as string, employee designation string, employee department as string once, and then row format delimited fields terminated by slash t. Slash t is nothing but we are terminating it by tab space value, like we are terminated the file by using a tab value. Okay, I will show you that. The data is separated by using the tab here, so that's why we are giving a slash t here. Okay, and stored as text file. Once I do that, the table is created. I am going to provide the show tables. The table is created with the table EMP1. I am going to load the data into the table. Load data in path. Load data local in path. and I am going to give the value of the path of the data, datasets slash module underscore hive slash lesson underscore 18 slash employee underscore data dot txt. I have the data in the path of datasets model 7 hive lesson 18 and employee data dot txt for your when you are using the data, you need to specify your path where you kept the data file. Okay, and I'm going to overwrite into the table, write into table emp1. The data is now loaded into the table emp1. Now I am going to describe the schema of the table. Describe emp1. Once I do that, we have created a table with the employee number as integer, name as string, designation as string, and department as string. Now we have loaded the data into it. We are going to do a select star from emp1, which will list all the data present in the emp1 table. Now I am going to do a select count operation on the employee designation. Employee designation, comma, count from EMP1. I'm going to group the data now. Group by employee designation. Once I do that, it will fire a MapReduce job. Once the MapReduce job is completed, we will have the employee designation count by the count. What it will do is that it will group all the employee designation. For example, a name is repeated twice or thrice, it will count the value and provide the result as per the existing one. Like if you see, system engineer is appearing in the data set as 5 times, so it has counted the value and provide the result as 5. Okay, likewise if you see like HR manager, it is repeated thrice. Okay, and now what we are going to do is that we are going to drop a manage table. Once we drop a table emp1, you will come to know what it does. Show tables once I type the command show tables, it has displayed the result with which denotes that the EMP1 table has dropped from our database. Okay, which means that the entire data and the metadata present inside the Hive database is totally gone from the Hive system. Okay, which denotes that the total file and the data and the metadata is deleted from the database table called Bala. From the database table, the total data is now deleted. This is the one drawback of the manage table. When we are going to use the external table, what is the main use of that is that once you drop the table, only the metadata will be lost. The data will reside somewhere in the HDFS file system or the Hive warehouse system. Okay, so it is always recommended when to use the manage table and then when to use the external table. Suppose we are using a managed table when a company is there, like they are having like to share the files. Okay, everyone need to share the data into that. At the time, we need to use the external table. Okay, when someone going to like manage table, in the sense some particular persons are using the data, at the time the manage table can be used. If we want to use the data collision, like we need to collide the data, at the time we can use the external table for sharing of the data. Okay, I hope everyone like this video. Please do subscribe, comments my video. Thanks for watching.